Dear student, welcome to EPG Pathshala. Today I am going to give lecture on the module Pesticide Degradation. The use of pesticide in India started in 1984 when DDT pesticide was imported for malaria treatment, and BHC, that is benzene hexachloride pesticide, it was imported for the treatment or the control of locust. Although the alarming rate of pesticide have been reported in our air, water, soil and even in the food, whereas most of the pesticide they have been reported to be mutagenic and carcinogenic. Hence the pesticide they have been considered to be very toxic to the environment also. Further, the most toxic pesticide in India are considered to be of organophosphorus and organochlorine type. In this module, students, we are going to learn about the pesticide degradation mechanism, the classification of pesticide, and also about the retention of pesticide on the soil. So first we are starting with the classification of pesticide. Classification of pesticide is done on the basis of their use and on the basis of their chemical constituent. Based on their use, there is a large variety of pesticide designed to kill specific pests. Those most widely used are listed below. First, insecticide, such as carbamates, organophosphates and organochlorines, they are used to kill insects. Then herbicides, they are particularly used for weed, and examples are glyphosate and propylene. Fungicides, they are used to kill molds or fungi. They are also called wood preservatives, so applied to the wood also. Rodenticides, then fumigants and other pesticides including miticides, algicides and acaricides, which are used to control ticks, are being used. Now, based on their chemical composition, organochlorine compounds, it consists of carbon atoms, chlorine, hydrogen and occasionally oxygen. They are soluble in lipids, so accumulate in fatty tissues of animals and are transferred through the food chain. Toxic to a variety of animals, long term persistent, example DDT, aldrin, chlordane and mirex. Another is organophosphate compounds. The organophosphate pesticides can be aliphatic, cyclic and heterocyclic, possessing central phosphorus atom in the molecule. They are soluble in organic solvent and also in water. They infiltrate reaching the groundwater but are less persistent than chlorinated hydrocarbons. They are absorbed by plants, transferred to leaves and stems, which are then supplied to leaf eating insects as feed. In insects, they affect the central nervous system. Example to this class, melathion, methylparathion and diazinon. Organotin compounds, presence of tin as central atom of the molecule. Organosulfur compounds, they have a sulfur central atom in the molecule and very toxic to mites or insects. Carbamates, the chemical structure is based on a plant aliquid, Physostigma venenosum. Carbamate acid derivatives kills a limited spectrum of insects but are highly toxic to vertebrates with relatively low persistence. Example, 7-carbaryl thiocarbamates. They differ from carbamates in their molecular structure, containing an sulfur group in its composition. Pyrethroids, the compounds are similar to the synthetic pyrethrins, aliquids obtained from petals of Zythinum cinerifolium. They affect the nervous system, are less persistent than other pesticides, are the safest in terms of their use. Some are used as household insecticides, example pyrethrins. Plant origin products, they are derived directly from plants, not chemically synthesized. Now, biological, only the Bacillus thuringiensis and its subspecies, viruses, microorganisms or their metabolic products are used. They are applied against forest, pests and crops, particularly against butterflies and caterpillars. Example, Dispel, Foray, Thuricide. Dinitrophenols, they are recognized by the presence of two nitro groups bonded to a phenol ring. Urea derivatives, the compounds include the urea bound to aromatic compounds, copper, inorganic compounds of copper. Diverse composition, triazines, carboxyamides, trichloroacetic and trichloropiconylic acids derivatives etc. are also some of the examples of pesticide based on chemical composition. Next is pesticide retention in soil. The retention of pesticide in soil mainly occurs due to the adsorptions in solute is retained to a solid absorbent surface, that is soil. The various processes possible for pesticide adsorption due to polar and ionizable groups present in soil are hydrogen binding, polar interaction, van der Waal dispersion forces, ion exchange, interaction with metallic cations, charge transfer and hydrophobic effects. Another process, desorption, which is reverse and is inversely related to adsorption. The various methods used for measurement of retention have been described below. First is our batch experiments, generally done by soil suspensions that retain the pesticides in accordance with OECD 106 guidelines. By this method, the degradation or the adsorption of pesticide on the surface of flask has to be determined. The quantity of pesticide retained in the soil is calculated as the difference between the initial concentration of pesticide in the solution and supernatant concentration that has been centrifuged. So, smaller the value of centrifugation, higher is the amount of pesticide absorbed per unit mass of the soil. However, this process has a drawback as dispersion of soil structures occurs due to intensive shaking of soil pesticide causing higher adsorption sites availability leading to overestimation of pesticide adsorption. Next is centrifugation. The sample treated with pesticide is incubated and centrifuged for collection of soil solution preceded by direct analysis for pesticide concentration. Filters. This method was developed majorly for undisturbed soil. In this method, 3 to 5 mm thick soil layer is developed by soil remolding at controlled water content. With help of glass microfiber filters, soil solution volume and dissolved pesticide concentration is measured on soil surface. Next process is soil columns. Under dynamic conditions, water flow is applied through rainfall. Simulation or pressure head control on a soil column with pesticide application. Determination of absorption coefficient can be done by inverse modeling of the elution curves and retardation factor calculation. Vertical distribution of the pesticide residues in the soil core could be estimated by such column experiments when leachate recovery is incomplete. Lysimeters. A cylinder with undisturbed soil block placed an inert container with a permeable bottom to drainage water or leachate. To represent crop practices under field climatic condition, this method is known for its efficacy to monitor mass fluxes of water and chemicals as well as their distribution, metabolites and transformation rate. The outdoor lysimetric studies show better results due to natural environmental field conditions with minimum disturbance in the soil structure but has a major drawback of variation caused by uncontrolled pedoclimatic conditions. Now the next topic is pesticide degradation in soil. The pesticides present in the soil degrade in the environment through physical, chemical and biological processes. The biodegradation of pesticide is influenced by soil properties such as pH, structure, moisture, temperature, organic matter content and the soil microbiota, microbes. Microbial degradation and microbial detoxification has been reported as the most promising and cost-effective method for the organic pollutant removal. Detoxification of pesticides and remediation of soil in the environment. The biotic transformation of pesticide is mediated by the microbiota while abiotic conversions occurs through chemical and photochemical processes and reactions. The structure and the environment conditions help in specific degradation reaction for a particular pesticide. The redox gradients in soil, sediments and aquifers occasionally are used to deduce the type of transformation that can occur. In a similar way, the photochemical transformation requires sunlight that is available only on the surface layer of lakes or rivers, plants or subsoil layers. Also, accumulation of biodegradation transformation intermediates occurs when the enzyme reaction rate decreases. affecting the production of intermediates. Pesticide degradation can occur by various mechanisms. Significant role played by physical, chemical and biological agents in insecticide, herbicides and fungicide transformation. Many soil applied pesticides are degraded more rapidly following repeated application at the same site. The transformation processes are oxidation, reduction, conjugation, hydrolysis, isomerization, hydration and silylation. The molecules of these are degraded at various resultant products that generally show lesser bioactivity as compared to the parent pesticides, but with exceptional cases, metabolites showing greater bioactivity have also been observed. There are structural changes that alter the physical chemical properties and significance of the degradation products. The introduction of environmental activation concept is done mainly to explain significance of the pesticide transformation into a degradation product in the environment as a result of its environmental toxicity or chemistry. As the pesticides begin to synthesize and purify, they begin to degrade. The process of formulation can initiate decomposition of active ingredients at a minor rate. The breakdown may also occur due to harsh environmental condition while the products are stored and shipped. The pesticide product may also degrade due to chemical interaction among parent molecules, water or other pesticides when prepared as a tank mix. They are attacked by detoxification enzymes in an organism on target and non-target sites. A part of pesticide applied always remains in environment as residue in soil, water and air that are subject to transformation by organisms uptake and moving toward different locations. Processes of pesticide degradation. The combination of physical, chemical and biological processes generally affect the breakdown of pesticide chemical over a time period. The pattern of chemical use, physical and chemical structure is the factor that affect the agents of transformation. Light and heat are the two primary physical agents implicated in the process of degradation. The photolysis of pesticide residues has significant impact on vegetation in water, soil surface and in the atmosphere. Photolysis and thermal decomposition of the chemicals is directly affected by sunlight and degradation is accompanied by photodegradative reactions. In cold or freezing conditions, suspensions or microencapsulations are the major process of pesticide degradation. The main factor responsible for breakdown of pesticide in solution in water along with pH extremes, even minor variation in pH can initiate rapid decomposition of pH sensitive compounds. Various oxidation products are generated from molecular oxygen and its other reactive forms, for example ozone, superoxides and peroxides. Various processes involved in pesticide degradation. Significant degradation occurs by biological agents such as microorganisms depending on their prevalence in the environment and on the prominence of pesticide collection in the media. The three major degradation strategies exhibited by microbes are co-metabolism, the process of biotransformation of pesticide molecule coinciding with the normal metabolic function of the microbial process of life, that is growth, reproduction and dispersal. Next is catabolism, the process of utilization of an organic molecule as an energy source or nutrient. In some cases, carbon or nitrogen is used as a sole source of energy, causing enhanced microbial disintegration. The relative ease of hydrolysis, the nutritional value of the hydrolysis product and the toxicity in the soil are the major factor affecting the resistance of the chemicals to EMD. Enzymatic processes, the enzymes are the digestion substrates, example phosphatase and amidases, and may persist in the soil even after death of the parent microbial cells. The extracellular enzymes can add the degradation process with capability of biochemical catalysis. Among other biological degradation agents like plants, invertebrates, vertebrates, later processes, the most advanced enzymatic arsenals for biotransformation of xenobiotics and also highest rate of detoxification and elimination. Biodegradation. There are three phases of enzymatic reaction that results into biodegradation of pesticides in the living being process. The process falls into three phases. Phase first, functional group reactions of the parent compounds by involvement of additional function groups. and resulting in the formation of physically and biologically modified metabolites. Phase 2, conjugation processes resulting in metabolite formation by linking of activated metabolites with cell constituents that are excreted or sequestered by the organisms. Phase 3, oligomerization process among several parent compounds or conjugation reactions between them resulting in formation of high molecular weight compounds that are incorporated and stabilized within the cell. The hydrophilic property of metabolites increase with decrease in mobility and toxicity as the various phase proceed, except in the case of polymers that are insoluble. Next come transformation. There are three basic types of reaction occurring in the transformation process: degradation, synthetic and rearrangement. The organic pesticide undergo various reaction before complete degradation, and the biological activity is altered by just one or two frequent transformation, generally by fourfold detoxification strategies. To facilitate elimination of the genobiotic molecule, it is transformed into a more water soluble and polar molecules like oxygen or oxygen containing moieties like sugar, phosphates, sulfates and amino acids. Secondly, the functional groups are altered in an attempt to render the less toxic molecules. In the third approach, breakdown to decrease the toxic impact of the chemical elements into two or more fragments occur. Additionally, the component parts of the molecule after the breakdown process are used as nutrient for microbial catabolism. Now, the figure 36.1, it is showing the process which is involved in the pesticide degradation. Next, factor controlling the retention of pesticide in soil. The physicochemical properties of pesticide as described below are controlling their retention in the soil. First is surface volume and branching. The adsorption of pesticide is directly proportional to the volume, solubility and degree of branching, which encodes the intermolecular accessibility and is correlated to the surface area. Next is electronic structure. The electronic structure of pesticide is determined by the nature of atom and functional group that governs the soil pesticide interaction. Adsorption is governed by molecular substitution, spatial arrangements and its influence the reactions between functional groups. Ionization, the charge of chemical determines ionization that depends upon the pH of the soil, pKa or pKb of the molecule in case of weak acid. Generally, the negatively charged surface like clays, hydroxides, humic substances and oxides show strong cationic adsorption, while anions have high adsorptions in the soil with positive charges. Hydrophilic or hydrophobic balance. The adsorption of pesticides increases with their hydrophobicity and decreases when they increase in water solubility because of their higher affinity for the water phases. However, it may also depends on the hydrophilic or hydrophobic balances of the soil adsorbents. Now, there are some examples given for showing the pesticide biodegradation processes. Structural changes or absolute degradation of pesticide is being carried out by microorganisms which chemically and physically have the ability to interact with substance. Bacteria, fungi and actinomycetes among the microbial population plays important role in pesticide degradation. Pesticide and other xenobiotics get biotransformed by fungi by introducing minor structural changes to molecules, depicting it harmless. Moreover, applying enzymes to transform or degrade pesticide is an excellent treatment technique for removal of these toxic chemicals from polluted environment. Pesticides may be more effectively degraded by enzyme catalyzed reaction than existing chemical methods. Phosphotriesterase belong to Pseudomonas diminuta MG shows high catalytic activity towards organophosphate pesticide is one example. Another is Flavobacterium ATCC27551 contains the OPD genes that encodes the PTE phosphotriesterase enzyme. These enzymes specifically hydrolyze phosphoester bonds, and the hydrolysis mechanism involves the water molecules at the phosphorus center. An example of the process is shown in parathion degradation pathway. Now, based on the metabolic products formed, the degradation pathway of chlorpyrifos by the strain Cladosporium cladosporidium Sporio, Cladosporium, Cladosporio does was proposed specifically. The fungus is capable for using chlorpyrifos as the sole carbon source. It is the first metabolized by hydrolysis to produce TCP, and then DETP is formed. The hydrolyzed product TCP was further transformed by breakage of ring, resulting in its complete detoxification. The whole process is shown in the figure. A number of bacteria capable of degrading carbofuran from the environment, such as Pseudomonas, Flavobacterium, Arthobacter, has been investigated. Carbofuran, extensively used in agriculture, is one of the pesticides belonging to the N-methyl carbamate class. It has been classified as highly hazardous and exhibit high mammalian toxicity. Carbofuran was degraded by Siphonogomonas species, first to carbofuran phenol, then to 2-hydroxy-3-phenol. And similarly, another species, Arthobacter species, was investigated for carbofuran degradation. The process is being shown in the figure given below. Students, in this lecture, we have learned about the classification of pesticide, which is based on their uses and also on their chemical composition. Further, we have also learned about the pesticide degradation mechanism, which usually takes place either on or near the soil surfaces. Moreover, the physical, chemical and biological processes lead to the breakdown of pesticides, and which also lead to the very complex processes we have seen during the lecture. Thank you.